It's Wolfie-chan, and I'm back with another anime review, and this one is Air Rekka 7. Oof. This one is a more older anime that I watched when I was in high school, and I really did fall in love with this one. It's around, more likely, our main character, Renton. And Renton has been on the Earth that's kind of been... How do I say this? It's... Like, the Earth has been crumbling, and just not really a great environment and stuff like that. Like, that's kind of what happened. So, he's been in this kind of junkyard with his grandfather and kind of place it in his life. Like, he doesn't know what's happening or what's going on. He just wants something new, wants something different. And then all of a sudden, this mech comes out of the sky, lands... Kinda. And he meets a new person called Eureka. Or Eureka. I'm not great with names, I'm sorry. And she's in a two-pilot mech. And she's kind of a strange creature and a strange person. Because she looks very different and she acts very different. And she herself is kind of in the middle of a lot of things. And so she's just trying to get away from stuff. And so Renton is like, well, I can help you. I don't know how to drive this thing, but I will try and help you the best he can. So he goes on an adventure with Eureka. And there's a whole thing about the anime that you can sky surf, in a sense. And it's all about catching the wind and catching at the right time. And so he learns it after like 5-6 episodes. It's kind of a bit. And it is a longer anime. And Eureka is part of this kind of special thing, which this special thing is kind of weird. What do I mean by that? Basically, it's like she was created, and then they don't want her to be seen by anybody, so they're trying to get her back. And then another mech pilot comes into the frame, and she's trying to hurt them as well, but that's later on in the anime series. They first get into basically the ship by people who are kind of like wind pirates. But they decide to protect Renton and Eureka. And Renton is getting more and more better at piloting the mech, this wonderful, beautiful mech that's there. And so, throughout the series, it's really heartbreaking because some things happen. Like, Eureka gets taken, and Renton doesn't know what to do because he's fallen in love with her, and he cares for her so much. And so they have to push, like, the captain of this thing has to push Renton to do something, you know? You gotta do something, man. You can't just, you know, you can't just do nothing, right? Of course, Renton, you know, he's... like, 10 years old, like, a little bit of a kid, doesn't know what to do, is special in that weird anime way. He's a really weird kid, I'll admit it, but I really do like him. Kind of. And the story does get a little bit jumbly sometimes, because it goes from that to Eureka's point of view, and she has adopted, like, these little kids that she wants to protect. And so, like, Renton and Eureka both kind of take care of them, and Eureka has, like, a certain hair, and then has a haircut, and she gets sick, and it's a very strange anime, but I will admit it was one of my more favorites at the time. And it was just really cool, because even in the end, which I'm not going to give you any spoilers about the fight scenes, what happens most in the anime, because it happens closer to the end, but they do kind of build a bond and kind of date each other. And that's kind of how the anime ends, is that they're together forever kind of thing. And the fun thing is they actually have a second season of it, which is Eureka 7 AO, I believe it's called. And I've watched that, and that kind of gives a little bit of depth more into the anime. But if you would like a review on that one, definitely tell me in the comment section below. But this is kind of one of those animes that it was made to stand out, that it was made to be different. And it does favor the differences of that anime. It is kind of strange at points in time, Like, it really is, and it's telling you it's Earth, but it's not, and there's this thing, and yeah, it's very, very interesting. And I really do love Eureka 7. It has been also a while since I've watched it, but I still love it, and I'm still a big fan of it. And if you like this video, definitely like. Leave in the comment section below, have you watched Eureka 7? And if so, what's your favorite character? I believe mine, if I can remember, was the captain. And the captain always had, like, a weird specialty in my heart, because he was, like, a saw dude kind of person. But he got serious when he needed to be serious. So, I think the captain of the ship that they are on is my favorite. And definitely subscribe if you haven't already, because I do upload every day something new, something old, or just something different that you may not have seen or heard about. And if you want to follow me on Twitter or Facebook for quick updates, there are links down below. I hope that you are having a very wonderful, wonderful summer. We keep getting rain. It's nice, but it kind of makes a warm mugginess around. Meh. Wolfie Chan out. Bye, guys.